Craig Cannon, thanks for joining us tonight. 4029's Damon Maloney joins us now live with our big story, and he's in Van Buren with details on the suspect's daring move. Damon.
Well, Craig and Donna, when employees here at the prosecuting attorney's office came to work this morning, they noticed that a Pepsi machine that used to be stationed outside their door, it had been broken into, and police say this wasn't the only machine that was targeted. Video captured from the prosecuting attorney's office shows a dark-colored two-door vehicle pulling up to the Pepsi machine. The male driver gets out, opens the door for his female passenger, and gets to work with a power drill in his hand.
He's kind of a really scrawny guy, so he ain't got a whole lot of muscle to put some power behind the drill itself, so it takes him a little bit to get it open.
It took the man less than 2 minutes to walk away with possibly $200 in coins and bills.
Begin investigating this as a simple break and entering into a vending machine, and now we've learned that we've had more.
Lieutenant Brent Grill with the Van Buren Police says someone also broke into these two vending machines early Thursday morning at a motel not far from the prosecuting attorney's office. Motel managers believe it happened sometime between midnight and 2:30 a.m.
But there was metal shavings all around, and they didn't take any of the cola or cokes or anything. They took the money.
Police say it will be just a matter of time before the bandits are behind bars.
So it's just fast money. It doesn't take there's no intelligence involved in it. You know, you just stick the drill in there, you defeat the lock, open it, and take the money.
Now, investigators were able to pull fingerprints off of the vending machine here at the prosecuting attorney's office. If the suspects are caught, they face felony charges of breaking and entering. Reporting live, I'm Damon Maloney, 4029 News.
Damon, real quick, did you say about approximately how much money they think they got away with?
Well, Brent Grill with the Van Buren Police Department says that the machine had been emptied relatively not too long ago, and that they got away with possibly $200.
Okay, thank you, Damon. Now, Police Department, the Van Buren Police Department is also working with the Fort Smith Police Department because they currently have several vending machine break-ins that are unsolved.